When you look out over a forest in Utah, whether from an airplane or hiking around, you might not realize that there's a library of information in those trees. Each tree is recording information about the environment that it's growing in.
The main focus of my work right now is to try to reconstruct stream flow from tree rings. The process is dendrochronology, so dendro for tree and chronology for time. We primarily take very small core samples. They're about the diameter of a pencil with a hand drill, and then we take it back to the lab. By cross-dating the rings in this dead tree with living trees, we'll be able to identify when this tree died.
Then we follow that up by measuring the rings to a thousandth of a millimeter, so it's very detailed work. When we have droughts, the rings are very narrow, and the more extreme, the narrower the ring. As we're trying to identify patterns in wide and narrow rings, you can kind of think of that as a barcode in the food that you might buy in the store. Trees in an area are going to have not exactly the same pattern, but a similar pattern of wide and narrow rings, just like that barcode. We get to the point where we can just look across a sample and say, okay, there's 1580 and there's 1735. We know where those difficult years are.
We're able to look at the records in the rings and from that reconstruct stream flow much further back than we can just with historical records. In some areas, under the best conditions with the best species, we can have up to a 10,000 year record from tree rings. We have maybe 50 to 100 years of historical records for the rivers around here, but we have trees that can go back several hundred years.
If you look at the Weber River, we have about 100 years of record. So that gives us a rough idea of how long droughts have been and how severe they've been, but it's only 100 years of record. And the trees have been around for 600 or 700 or more years, and they can give us a much longer record of those droughts. Sometimes, as we look in the tree rings, we see droughts that are much longer or much more severe than anything we've seen in the historical record. We've had droughts that have lasted for more than a decade. We had one that lasted for 16 years. Water managers can actually incorporate those into forecast models to help us better prepare for droughts in the future. We're excited to be able to take the information and give that to water managers now because they haven't had that for the Wasatch Front before.